first stated communication of St. Mark's Lodge No. 7 was held on January 16, 1852 in Columbus, Ohio. The Grand Master at that time was Most Worshipful Griffin T. Watson, who granted the Brethren permission to create the first Prince Hall Lodge of Free and Accepted Masons in the city of Columbus. St. Mark's was the fourth Prince Hall Lodge founded in the state of Ohio. The lodge numbers were consecutive for only the first three lodges due to other lodges being warranted outside of the state by this Grand Lodge. To understand and appreciate the accomplishments of our early brethren, we must first place the creation of our lodge into historical context. During the 1850s, Harriet Beecher Stowe's novel Uncle Tom's Cabin focused national attention on the cruelties of slavery. This brutal institution was still ingrained in the American culture. The Supreme Court decided in the Dred Scott case that an African American could not be a citizen of the United States and thus had no rights of citizenship. In 1850, President Millard Fillmore signed a new fugitive slave law into law. This law established a $2,000 fine and 6 months in prison for anyone harboring runaway slaves. It also permitted kidnapping of free blacks in the North to return to bondage. Columbus, Ohio in the mid-19th century had approximately 1,277 blacks in the city. During that time, many African Americans were engaged as laborers, barbers, cooks, waiters, shoemakers, stable owners, and auctioneers. As Linwood G. Davis wrote, one of the reasons blacks settled in Columbus prior to 1850 was the relative security of the central location. It was such conditions both on national and state level that motivated our early brethren to establish an assigned lodge in Columbus, Ohio. The first officers of St. Mark's were Charles M. Langston, Worshipful Master, David Jenkins, Senior Warden, and Hanson Johnson, Junior Warden. Brother Langston and Brother Jenkins were both involved in the early abolitionist movement in Ohio. Brother David Jenkins was born in Lynchburg, Virginia in 1811. At various times in his life, he was a farmer, barber, paper hanger, and a painter, as well as an energetic operator in the local Underground Railroad. He came to Columbus in 1837, where he became a leading participant in the local civil rights activities. He was a recruiter for the 127th Infantry during the Civil War and was then appointed to the Freedmen's Bureau of Mississippi. He also published the Palladium of Liberty in 1843 with a group of free blacks in the Columbus area. Our first Worshipful Master was also very active in the anti-slavery movement. Brother Charles Langston was born in Virginia in 1817. His youngest brother, Brother John Mercer Langston, also a member of our lodge, was also very actively involved in the abolitionist movement, organizing anti-slavery societies locally and at the state level. Brother Charles Langston in 1836 established a school in Chillicothe, Ohio for African American children. Brother Langston was appointed principal of the Columbus Colored School in 1856. He was also a conductor on the Underground Railroad, and in 1858 was convicted for breaking the Fugitive Slave Act. 20 Oberlin residents, including Brother Langston, was arrested and put on trial for their roles in the Oberlin-Wellington Rescue, which involved assisting a fugitive slave escape to Canada. After the Civil War, Langston moved to Kansas, where he became principal of the colored school there. He also served as Grand Master of the Prince Hall Grand Lodge of Kansas. Good men have always been attracted to St. Mark's. A look at the roster of our membership over the years may be compared to a who's who list of black Columbus. Three early individuals who were on both lists were Brother Hanson Johnson, Brother J.J. Lee, and Brother James Poindexter. Brother Johnson served as Worshipful Master from 1871 to 1873. Past Master Johnson was a barber, and he was said to be the wealthiest black community member in Columbus, with a property valued at $12,000 in 1860. His expertise served our lodge well. Brother Lee was Worshipful Master in 1904. Past Master Lee was one of the first blacks elected to a public office in Columbus. He served on the Columbus Board of Education. The first African-American to serve on the Columbus Board of Education was Brother James Poindexter. Brother Poindexter was another member who stood tall in the face of adversity by participating in the Underground Railroad movement. He supplied horses and materials to escape slaves and assisted them in their journey toward freedom. During the Civil War, Brother Poindexter and his wife formed the Colored Soldiers Relief Society due to the lack of support for African-American soldiers by the state of Ohio. With the new century upon us, St. Mark's continued to thrive and help spread Freemasonry in this jurisdiction. On November 18, 1913, St. Mark's inaugurated the first of the Masonic schools. Brothers from all around the jurisdiction had come to Columbus to learn the proper way to do degree work. As Charles Wesley wrote in our Grand Lodge history book, the Hall of St. Mark's set a high standard for degree proficiency that has been passed down to the brothers who now fill our beloved Lodge Hall. In 1919, Brother John C. Logan, who had served our Lodge as Worshipful Master, was elected to the highest office in our mystic circle, that of Grand Master of Masons. Past Grand Master Logan was described as a man of keen understanding, executive ability, good fellowship, and with the confidence the Masons in Ohio reposed in him, he brought this grand jurisdiction up to the standard that was the peer of any organization. The project that St. Mark's began in 1919 was the building of a Masonic Hall. Before our present building, the brethren met on the second and third floors of the building located at 247 North 4th Street. A Go-Getters Club was organized in the early part of 1919. It consisted of the younger members of the Lodge, with Brother John P. Biles, past master, chairing the committee. The brothers had raised $4,000 by 1920, which was enough to make a down payment on a site. The committee began looking for an appropriate site to build our temple. East Long Street in Miami was chosen. The owner of the property advised the committee that in no case would he make a direct sale to the brethren due to their race, but he would sell through some third person of the opposite race, through whom the title could be passed to the Lodge. The committee did find such a person. On June 28, 1920, the deal for the purchase of the property was completed and the deed turned over to St. Mark's. The building was completed and the Lodge room was dedicated on January 15, 1927, 75 years after our Lodge was founded. St. Mark's members continued to care about the black community in Columbus. Brother William A. Method was a Harvard-trained surgeon. Brother Method could not practice at certain hospitals in Columbus due to his race. This forced him and other black physicians to turn over their patients to white doctors if they needed any type of surgical procedure. In 1920, he opened Alpha Hospital, which was located on Long Street, to serve the black community. Dr. Method was known as the Dean of Negro Physicians, training several students in the practice of medicine. He employed several people in the area as well as the best surgeons of the city. Alpha Hospital expanded to a social agency, thus the Alpha Hospital Association was formed by Dr. William Method as Chief of Staff. In 1928, Hathaway Meadows decided to petition St. Mark's Lodge and was found worthy of admission. Brother Meadows was very active in our fraternity for over 70 years. Brother Meadows entered the Grand Lodge above on June 10, 2003. He was 105 years old at the time of his passing. At the time of his death, he was the oldest Prince Hall Mason in the state of Ohio. During the decades of the 40s, World War II dominated the world's attention. A lot of the brethren of St. Mark's went overseas to fight in the war. Many of the brethren wrote the Lodge detailing their experiences on the battlefields of Europe as well as the South Pacific. In 1949, St. Mark's once again had the pleasure of having one of its members elected as Grand Master. Brother A.J. Worship, who served as Worshipful Master of St. Mark's from 1931 to 1933, was elected at the 100th Grand Communication of the Most Worshipful Prince Hall Grand Lodge of Ohio. Past Grand Master Worship once stated, "Every Prince Hall Mason ought to be an informed Mason, schooled in his history and tradition as well as in his rituals." In 1952, St. Mark's celebrated a milestone in Masonic history, its 100th anniversary. The brethren and guests filled our ballroom to capacity to celebrate the founding of one of Columbus's oldest institutions. Also during the 50s, St. Mark's membership reached an all-time high, with 630 brothers on its roll. At the 122nd Grand Communication, Brother K. Kenneth Williams was elected to serve as Most Worshipful Grand Master. He became the third member of our lodge to serve in this grand capacity. Brother Williams instituted the protocol manual that we use in our lodges throughout the state. He also, during his tenure, demanded a high degree of excellence in our ritualistic work. In the 70s, 80s, and 90s, the brethren once again carried the eagerness to recapture that St. Mark's splendor. We raised many good men during these years. The brothers once again accepted the challenge of preserving our rich traditions and improving on them. At the 146th Grand Communication held in Columbus, Ohio, St. Mark's again had one of its members, Brother Frederick E. Kelly, elected to the office of Most Worshipful Grand Master. In 1997, St. Mark's became one of the first lodges within the state of Ohio to have its own website. Since it was designed and went online, stmark7.org has kept the lodge's membership up to date on lodge functions and news. With the majority of people now getting their information via the World Wide Web, our website has informed the general public on our extensive history, in addition to serving as the first interaction that some potential members have with the lodge. It has been a tool that we have used to move St. Mark's into the current time. During the 2010 Masonic year, St. Mark's inaugurated the John A. James Multiple Sclerosis 5K Run Walk in Columbus, Ohio. The event was named after Brother John A. James, who was a long and dedicated member and who has MS. The lodge worked with the National MS Society to bring awareness to this disease. During the 162nd Communication of the Most Worshipful Prince Hall Grand Lodge of Ohio in 2011, Brother Johnny O. Pitts Sr. was elected the 60th Most Worshipful Grand Master. Brother Pitts became the 5th past master of our lodge elected to this high honor. Currently in its third century of existence, St. Mark's is once again willing to accept the challenges of building on the accomplishments of our early brethren. As past Grand Master K.K. Williams number 7 remarked during a Grand Lodge session, "Prince Hall Masons cannot live by our past alone. We must revise and update our thinking so that it fits today's needs." Indeed, with new programs being instituted to help the lodge and the community, the brethren are prepared to carry on our rich tradition.
But I know change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. I go to the movie and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me, don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother and I say, brother, help me, please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Oh, there have been times that I thought I couldn't last for long. But now I think I'm able to carry. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.